So folks, welcome to this episode of The Rumble. My guest today is a young lady. She's an actress. I might as well tell you that straight away. Sometimes I just keep her in suspense. Like, can you figure out who she is? Okay, she's an actress. So welcome to the show, Anjana.
Hi.
You're Anjana Menon, right?
Hello.
Okay, so tell me, I heard of multilinguals, but this multilingual beats everything. You're doing four languages at one go.
Yes.
Isn't that
it's quite an attempt, but the director was very particular that he wanted the...
Okay, which language is the director from?
The director is actually an Andhra person.
Okay, so he speaks Telugu.
Yes.
So the movie is fundamentally a Telugu movie.
He's familiar with all the languages. Not all the fluent, but he's familiar with all the four languages. Being in the direction industry, I think they tend to be...
Oh, they must be watching.
Yes.
And the piracy industry keeps them with DVDs
Absolutely.
Too.
Absolutely.
So you can watch that. Yeah. So the four languages being done is only for the market's sake, or it is actually... What's the rationale behind doing four together?
Four languages, I guess he staunchly believes that the story can be communicated in all the four languages, because there are certain threads which can cater to audience of all South Indian.
Okay, some don't.
Yeah.
Alright, so in your case, this always intrigues me. How do you go about and select a particular script or a particular story? I say, that sounds intriguing, because we hear that very often,
right.
We read about it.
Right.
What's your technique?
Well, I'm still young, my first film was in Malayalam. It's called Traffic. Traffic went on to be a blockbuster. And I was quite a novice then. Mm-hmm. As in, I was not very...
You said it's your first movie.
Yeah.
What's your first? So you were a novice,
But there are a lot of people who come into the industry with the clear-cut attitudes and plans of how to go about the whole thing. But Traffic was just like, you know...
like a block in traffic just happened.
Yeah, just happened. And it just came through a common friend of mine and the director, Rajesh Pillai.
Okay.
So just the kick of getting into movies... Got me.
So that you are looking out for something.
I was not really keen about making it big in the film industry as such, but then Traffic went on to be a superhero apparently, so that got me interested.
And that also was done in other languages, for what I know.
Yes, later on after the film.
Did you get involved with those versions?
Not really.
No. So you
because I guess none of them from the Malayalam Traffic were involved in the other
So tell me, how do you select a movie? So let's say now on, in future. What would you do? Is there some...
Certainly, when you select a movie, the director is important.
Okay.
The repute of the director is certainly important.
And that will be an overriding consideration. Or would you say,
The script, and of course, even if you're going with a new director, you need to know his works. Yeah.
So do they tell you?
You need to know his works and you need to get a fair idea of what he's been doing, you know?
So we hear disconcerting stories that stories are not completed, the script is not done, people are writing stuff on the sets and it just goes along in a kind of slapdash affair. So an actor or an actress may not even be aware of his or her role until it gets going. Is that true?
Well, frankly, you want the real story? Frankly, it does happen.
Okay.
Because
more often than not?
It depends a lot on the kind of style, the direction style that he follows. There are certain people who a little bit of eccentricity or...
That helps.
Creative people, right? So that helps. At that point in time, wherein they have maximum thought flow and maximum imagination coming in, probably half an hour before the shoot actually starts and the camera opens. So
they also mentally warm up and they're all ready to go, right?
Yes. So different people, there are different kinds of people, and it's very interesting to know that you have a different range of psychological emotions that you play with, the getting to know the different kind of directors. And they're a little eccentric.
So you're not too hung up on having a pre-prepared script and all that jazz. If it's not their time.
Pre-prepared. As an artist, I would definitely want to have a script And I would definitely want to know what I'm getting into and get into the skin of the character.
So when you have all these North Indians coming out here and acting in movies, the language obviously no clue about.
Right.
How do they pull it off, or they just muddle their way through?
Well, that you're going to ask them, I guess. I think.
Well, that's probably in Telugu, for example.
Well, initially when they explain the script to you. The character starts playing on your mind, and then you automatically, especially when the South Indian languages are concerned, I'm familiar with most of the South Indian languages, so I can think in all the four South Indian languages.
So do you make, in this particular one, it's a four language version,
yeah.
Have you made up your mind to slightly play differently in the four, or you want to do
play differently, because the ask of the four languages is a little different.
Yeah.
Maybe a subtle difference, but there is.
Would somebody be actually telling you that?
Telling me that in terms of. The director does give me a little bit of guidance on which emotion has to be brought down, or which one has to be exaggerated in which language.
Okay. So that's important. Yeah. Tell me extremely loud in some languages.
Yeah, so that really helps.
Okay. So then, when we talk about getting a co-star, which is as critical, I know co-stars and the star sometimes probably appear together maybe just for 2-3 minutes in some movies, and then the different players are having a play. How important is it to know this guy whom you're playing the main part opposite? Is it critical?
I think initially, when you get into the industry, you really need that the chemistry with your co-star to build up. Even before the shot happens, because I guess that really works in terms of timing, picking up the timing and getting to know how the person is likely to react, or
she has her own plan and she's building the whole thing ahead, but just as important is how important are the senior actors in to a novice newcomer. Are the seniors any good? We'll find that when we come back. So talking about senior actors or co-stars, are they helpful, forthcoming?
Well, frankly, some of them give you very good inputs. For example, I have been working, the last schedule I have been working with Suman sir. He's a man of great repute, and he made me feel so comfortable on the set. I was a little bit wary about, you know, how the whole combination scene is going to work out, because it's in four languages at a stretch. As in, it's like you complete a conversation.
Oh, at the same time, one after
a conversation in one language, and then you go to the next, and then next. So it goes on like that.
Okay.
So it was quite, he made me feel
How is he? He takes these four languages easily, just because he's a professional with experience?
Well, I guess he's been in the industry for a long time. And I guess acting, it's not about the language. I think it's the core focus is on the expression. So language is, in fact, just, I would say, probably take a backseat when it comes to emoting.
Yeah, so there was a conversation once I had with an actress from Bollywood who came here. And I thought she was a well-known face, and eventually it was her, but I wasn't sure it was her. And I asked her, how are you acting in Tamil? Do you know Tamil? Do you speak? She says, no, I was told by some other actor that you just say ABCD and get by with that. So she's continuously saying ABCD, this ABCD, ABCD. So it's the expression, as you said, is if you sound right, if you look right, then people are not really looking too closely at your lips and you'll get by, they'll slow a frame down.
There are cases wherein you have close-ups and right in front of your nose.
But then that would be short lines, won't they be? I mean, it won't be long dialogues.
We do have long dialogues as well.
Yeah, so
Basically, I'm playing a cop in the film, so there are a few dialogues that I have to stress on.
Okay.
And I don't have a choice but to pronounce the dialogues accurately.
All right. So you can't hide it.
Quite a challenge.
Yeah, but and now the technology is changing, where I think multiple cameras on the set are catching you from all sides. You don't have to keep doing it and over again, reaction shots. How is it? How are you shooting? Is it single camera or multi camera?
In fact, we do have multi-cams in certain shots, which really can't be repeated.
Okay.
And there are shots wherein we do use a single camera as well, which have to be probably repeated. For some reason or the other, the shots have to be repeated. So
maybe they don't have a camera. That's the reason. They haven't spent the money.
No, not essentially. Probably it might work out cost effective for simpler scenes to use.
Yeah, that's true. It was like reactions. So yeah. you keep
nodding
your head.
Certain scenes which must, which requires multicams. And certain action scenes and stuff like that, which cannot be.
Yeah, and then four languages mean virtually four movies, which means four costumes. Or are you wearing the same costume in all movies? Will that change?
I play a cop.
So you only wear khaki anyway.
Yeah, it's a khaki, but again, the cap is different.
Ah, and you have the APPP
badge,
thingy.
The badge is different, the belt is different. So each shot, each language, we've got to keep changing the cap.
So is there somebody keeping track of that?
Of course. The costumers are... That's their job. Yeah.
So we keep reading about this continuity girl, continuity guy. That's his job make sure that...
Continuity, I guess it's one of the most challenging aspects of cinema, because there was a time in cinema long ago, wherein people never used to look at these kind of audience. Never used to.
And they didn't bother with it.
Yeah.
You know,
they never used to see whether you're wearing the same color dress
In fact, I think there was a film magazine which used to specialize in catching all these bloopers. Like, you know, he walked into the room wearing a yellow shirt, then he walked out wearing a blue shirt. When did he change his clothes?
Maybe a few critics here and there. Probably the audience have matured so much over time, and especially one of the most intimidating audience would be probably the Malayalam audience is very intelligent.
Mm-hmm.
A Malayali audience is very intelligent. Of course, all the states, the audience have come up to a different level wherein they start criticizing each and every.
So you like this business of people walking into a theater and starting to hit Twitter within the first 20 minutes of the movie saying,
it's a terrible movie, stay away, come here. Not really.
Instead of shooting the...
It really kills the spirit of cinema.
There's one who said instead of shooting the movie, they should have shot the hero.
God.
Using live ammunition.
Everyone can come up with a line.
I know, and
clever
line.
And the worst part is it's on media. So there are thousands of people reading it, and there are thousands of people
and building an opinion on that.
So it's a real sad scenario, because there's a lot of effort that goes into a film.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of positive energy from people from different walks of life, the direction side, the production side, and there's been so many hardships.
So you think it's unfair what is going on, going to theaters and doing all this?
We would say it's unfair because after coming into the industry, I really feel the pain of it.
Before that, you didn't think too much about it.
Because before that, I was just looking at cinema as an audience. But now the perspective of viewing cinema...
Yeah, you put all your effort in and people don't go to see it.
Yes. Essentially, I don't think they should build an opinion based on one person's view or one person's critical...
Yeah, but then that's what critics do. That's their job, to criticize.
It's their job, but don't kill a film in a day or two.
Okay, so 5 days later, you slaughter it, it's okay. So you made four days of money.
At least people can build an opinion. Let people watch it.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah, I heard a situation where somebody told me that they had these electronic jammers.
Mm-hmm.
You can activate them in a theater and your phone go dead. So when you come back, I want to really talk to you guys out there who go to see movies, and we're going to jam all you miserable people sending out nasty tweets. We'll jam you chaps. We'll find out more. So there must be a lot of people watching this, so I like to ask for a little bit of advice from her. You know, people who want to get into this field, do they need to learn anything specific before they get into it? You know, like acting talent?
Acting talent, it's of course, I guess...
Not
most
talent,
of the...
lessons, I guess. Take acting lessons.
Yes, I guess most of them who enter the industry at the moment are pretty prepared. I mean, they are pretty familiar with the camera, and they know how to handle the camera.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people from the media industry get in and... it's been like, unlike yesteryears, it's been like much more easier for I've got to know from.
How about the difference between television and movies? What is the, in your mind, what is the real difference?
I guess both are media, and television is a big enough media as well.
Okay. So still, there's this hankering. I don't want to be called a TV star.
There's this thing about, but I guess it's just in the head. 70mm screen, of course, has a different impact. So, okay. Definitely.
That's the magic?
That's the magic.
Yeah.
And TV shows, anchoring TV shows, and I think they give you a lot of popularity. I mean, off late, the TV anchors have gained much more popularity than probably their counterparts.
Yeah, that's true. So, you got to think on your feet. You'll be quick. There's no script to...
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
So that's a different ballgame altogether. Mm. Acting is tough, but at the same time, that's tough as well.
But being live on a show, especially a reality show,
there's
only a limited number of things that you are asked to do.
Mm-hmm.
But cinema is nothing like that.
Cinema,
there are no boundaries. I mean, you could go be a jet pilot into a deep sea diver or a dancer.
Yes, I guess there are a certain set of characters that suit you the most, and depending upon your face and your body language and a lot of things.
So, do you have a preference?
In fact, I always wanted to play a cop.
Your dreams
something...
come true.
Yeah, I could say so.
No, because a lot of people say that I don't care whether the role, just give me the role, I'll play it. So there must be something
that
you like.
Yes, definitely. There is of course a preference, but then you can't be too particular about doing only these kind of roles, because
I mean, did you look for something, say, hey, at some time I must do something like this?
Yes, of course. I wanted to play a cop, and this happened. It was quite a destiny's call. This just happened when I was...
Did any other actor, actress influence you in your choice of career? It's like, hey, I want to be like her. Or when you're young, you grew up watching somebody.
Well, I think I've always been very fond of Angelina Jolie.
All right. And somebody closer to home?
Closer to home? Probably Kajol. The kind of magic she used to... bring, the kind of spontaneity she used to bring on screen was...
Who's
like
the equivalent of that
amazing
in South Indian cinema? Is anyone? Anybody in Malayalam?
Well, Manju Varier, of course.
Okay, sure.
I liked her spontaneity, and I think it could well be compared to Kajol.
Yeah, okay. But she left early, and I don't know whether she's going to come back. But people missed her, I think, probably because of that.
Well, she's come back.
Yeah, but
how old are you? Seemingly one of the best comebacks in the last
The movie's
series.
Already out. You've seen
yes,
it?
Yes, yes.
Okay, and you think it's a great one? Good,
yes,
good
yes,
job?
Yes, yeah. It's been a good hit across.
Okay.
So, and
does it lend itself to other languages, that kind of movie, whatever she did?
Yeah, certainly. It's a movie that's applicable to all languages.
So in Malayalam, do you see a type of movie which will work better than other languages? You know, like say
in Malayalam, of course, no. No, there is no A type of movie.
No,
it can be a thoroughly rustic sort of thread, or it can be a thoroughly new genre sort of generation sort of film. Anything can.
But
just
what works best in your mind?
Well,
for Malayalam, because you've chosen to do Malayalam films.
Well, both are doing equally good, parallelly. That is quite a, you know...
And the older time generate, though, I wouldn't say older time, the generation who directed movies, like say 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Is there a drastic change from today's
of
directors?
Of course, there is.
They've changed their style because the public also likes
they,
it.
Yeah, they have. They are making attempts to change their style, and they are able to successfully catch up with the public now.
So how come in Kerala so many Tamil pictures are hits? What is it that grips them about Tamil movies?
There
they won't allow it in Malayalam.
There is this X factor about Tamil films. Just watching a Tamil film gives them that adrenaline rush, and watching a Surya or Vijay or Ajit.
So we haven't. It's not there in Malayalam.
Well, Malayalam, I think predominantly scripts have been ruling off late. Scripts have been the real heroes. As in, we have wonderful actors like Lalit and Mamukka, but definitely the script plays the most predominant role.
So you
and
can switch
proved,
an actor?
That has been proved. I guess ever since I've done Traffic, that has been a trend that script plays a real hero, you know.
So you don't need a big star, is what you're saying?
Well,
I mean, it helps.
Yeah, you need good actors who can communicate because the roles are that the characters they sketch out are very intense and they are.
Do we ever take pictures from overseas, Hollywood, and make it into Malayalam? I know they do it into Hindi, but do we take stories from there, or is it still Kerala and
it's
our trade secret? So who's keeping that secret? I wonder. No, because any hit in Malayalam, we'll, of course, we'll have the Malayalam essence in it.
Definitely, there is a lot of essence that is being borrowed from... that happens, right? I mean,
sure.
Creative industry, definitely there's a lot of ideas that have been taken from other languages. And especially off late. You know, okay. Hollywood films and French films have
Korean
really...
Films.
Korean films.
Yes.
Have really influenced Malayalam cinema.
Okay, so script writers and story writers, they're taking a backseat today by having borrowed a lot from overseas, or they're still coming out with original stuff?
Well, the final outcome is, of course, original, because we Malayalis are very quick at finding out whether it's a... You know, complete.
Do they send messages to each other?
Probably, it's just communicated.
How about the critics? Are they really critical out there in Malayalam?
Very, very critical.
I mean, they tear you apart if they've done something silly? Or do they just let it go?
There are shows in Malayalam which literally, you know, every single scene, they might tell you which is the expression that has gone a little lesser than it's required.
Or more than it ought to be.
And stuff like that. So, the critics are very sharp.
You faced that any time so far?
Malayalam, I'm still young, so...
Not yet?
Not yet.
All right, on that happy note, thank you for coming. Anja, we shall meet again when you crack those big numbers, get your names up in lights. Best of luck.